Hi, everyone. It's Jean Sachs. I'm the CEO of Living Beyond Breast Cancer. And first and foremost, I hope you're all staying well and taking good care of yourself during this challenging time. Today, we have an opportunity to hear from Dr. Jill McDevitt. She is a sexologist. She is a coach, a sex educator, a consultant, and also the resident sexologist for CalExotics. And I want you all to know that CalExotics has been an incredible partner of Living Beyond Breast Cancer since 2008. And over that time, they have donated well over $200,000 to support our mission. So we're so grateful for them. And they created a line called the Inspire line that has a whole bunch of products that can be beneficial to those who maybe are struggling with sexuality post a breast cancer diagnosis. And every time those products are purchased, a percentage of sales goes back to support our mission, which is really incredible. So welcome, Dr. Jill, and thank you again for taking the time to join us.
My pleasure. Happy to be here.
Yeah. So maybe we could start, and if you could just tell us, what is a sexologist? Because I think it might be a term not everyone's familiar with.
Sexology is the scientific study of human sexual behavior. So it looks at what we do as humans sexually and why we do it. So I have a bachelor's degree in sexuality, marriage, and family, and a master's in human sexuality education and a PhD in human sexuality. So I just studied sexuality for many years, and I get to help people in all different kinds of ways, doing education, doing coaching, consulting. I love my job. It's a great career.
So we know when a woman is diagnosed with breast cancer, it is a medical crisis. It's also a financial crisis, but it's also often a crisis of their identity and really can impact their intimate relationships, whether their bodies have changed because they've lost a breast or two breasts, or they have reconstruction that may or may not be what they wanted. Many women are thrown into early menopause surgically or medically, and they may have gained weight or lost weight, and they really struggle. So maybe let's just start to say, tell us why sexual health is important at all stages of life and no matter what you're going through.
I say that sexuality isn't something that we do, it's something that we are. And it embodies a part of our humanity, and it's a vital part of our humanity, I believe. And so when anything happens into our lives, it affects and it ripples our sexuality and vice versa. And so when we're talking about something as impactful as a cancer diagnosis and the changes you mentioned with treatments or losing breasts and things of that nature, it can be a shock and a major disruption to the sexual piece as well as a human. So the way one relates to themselves, the way they relate to a partner, the way they experience their bodies as sexual beings in the world and their gender and how gender shows up, pleasure in their body, all these pieces come together. So it's to even just have this conversation and to acknowledge that these are valid questions and concerns that people might be having about their sexuality and how it's impacted is really important.
So we know breast cancer treatment impacts your hormonal status, which obviously can impact, you may be experiencing more vaginal dryness, you may be experiencing new pains. Tell us, like, what are some of the things you could use both for vaginal lubricants or starting to get reconnected with sensations?
So there's a few things here to address. That one is a mindset piece, and that is looking at sexuality and sexual activity through a broader scope. And so if there are certain things that are no longer accessible sexually or are no longer pleasurable sexually, that it can be an opportunity to be curious and to explore new and different ways to experience. So if penetration feels really painful or is, if there's a certain sex act that feels triggering or is in a part of the body that doesn't feel sexual anymore or what have you, that there can be new and different ways, that sexuality isn't a box that just means, you know, A to B and B to C. We can make up our own ways that feel good to us. So one is getting a mindset change that there's not really a deficit, there's just a change. Mm-hmm. As far as what sexuality looks like. With that said, if in fact, you know, doing certain sex acts is really important and is something that you really want to explore and to do, for example, penetration of some kind, but that's painful, this is where the CalExotics Inspire line comes in to help try to bridge some of these gaps and to develop the changes. So for instance, one product is the 5-set dilator piece. And so the dilators are designed to help with the elastic changes in the vagina that can take place with treatment. And so here's what they look like. So it's just a skinny little silicone and lubricated. It would go into the vagina. And I have Margot, the vulva puppet, here to help demonstrate it. So if you put in and then kind of do circular rotations over time, this is going to help maintain the ability to have penetration. Now, once that feels comfortable, then you can increase and you keep, and it comes with a set of 5. And so you can keep gradually helping the muscles and this elastic skin get more and more comfortable with bigger pieces. So this can help significantly with the vaginal pain from penetration that can occur. So that's one example.
Yeah. So Dr. Jill, just because I know for some of our people, they might not have ever thought about a dilator or know what they are. So they're really a tool for you to use on your own, right? It's not so much a sex toy, or it's not really a vibrator, but it is something to open up the vaginal wall. So eventually you could have penetration if that's what you're looking to do, right?
Yes. So it's kind of a preparation tool to help not only maintain the elasticity that already exists, but to expand its capacity so that in the future penetration can be easier. And also just things like gynecological exams and things of that nature can also be easier.
So I know along with that is a lot of us have heard about the importance of your pelvic floor muscles. It's always an interesting phrase to me, like pelvic floor, where is that? And I know that some people call it your core muscles. So tell us about the Kegel exercises. And some people, they think they're doing it right, but they may not be actually doing it right.
Great questions. All true. So the pelvic floor is a great way to explain it, because the scientific word for it is like 19 letters long. I can barely pronounce it. It's pubococcygeus muscles, I think. I might be saying it right or wrong. We just call it the pelvic floor. It's fine. So it's the band of muscles that connects, you know, the front to back to the pubic bone to the tailbone. And then there's this way. So it's kind of like a little hammock, and it supports all, you know, organs, the intestines and all those things that holds up. And it also is something that impacts the way that we feel sexually. So it's the sensations that happen with a stronger pelvic floor. Sensations are more easily felt. So it's a health as well as a pleasure component sexually. And so one way to strengthen them, because they tend to become looser over time just because gravity, you know, but also it is impacted by losing elasticity and atrophy of muscles as well. So the Kegel exercise is a way to work out those muscles, if you will. And the way they're done correctly is to clench and release the muscle that you would use if you were you had to urinate really bad, but you had to hold it and you had to squeeze. The key is, and I think people may have heard that kind of analogy before, but the key is the second piece is the relaxing. So it's the two-step muscle, just like think about a bicep with a dumbbell, right? If you lifted it and then just kind of held it there, you would strain the muscle versus the release and the contraction, the release and the contraction. So that's the two pieces, is the clenching of the pelvic floor muscle and then the relaxing of the pelvic floor muscle. So that is one complete exercise. And just like doing our muscles or any other type of physical exercise, it's repetition and it is time. So it's giving yourself the space to, you know, not do one of these and think you're going to have bulking biceps. Same idea with the pelvic floor. And you can do those on your own, just like I described, or again, in the Inspire line by CalExotics has little vagina dumbbells. Like they're little weights called Kegel exercisers, and they're little weighted ball like pieces that are inserted. And then you gotta clench to hold them in and then release. And so it helps you along and builds a resistance as well.
And that is helpful to do, you know, just to continue to do throughout your life, right? This is something that should just be a regular practice, right?
Yeah. It's something I recommend just as a thing to do for vaginal health in general and sexual health in general.
Great. So is there anything else in that line you want to share with us? I know you might have a vibrator or something else or to tell us about.
Yes, there is the vibrator. It's the flickering intimate arousal, and it's not scary, right? It's cute, it's pink, and it's what I like about it is that it's very ergonomic. You see, it fits in the hand just like very naturally. So it makes it very accessible. And then this piece at the end will go over the clitoris, and there's a little flickering kind of piece there that will be like a tongue almost. So going back to our friend Margot, the vulva puppet here. So you would just kind of hold it over the clitoris like this, and it has multiple speeds with a button here. And so this is, again, something you can use with yourself to explore pleasure, to give yourself something joyful in this world that can center something positive and connecting back to the body. It's also something that can be used with a partner.
Right. So if someone has never used any of these products, you know, just something not in there, something that they just never thought about, how can you help people feel comfortable just trying something new? You might not like it, but you might, right?
You might. Yeah, I think first what I like to say is that, like, it's okay that at first this feels scary, because we're culturally not taught that sexuality and sexual health and sexual pleasure is a valid thing to pursue or to care about. So to go out and search for and find and use tools that will improve your sexual experience is a little counterintuitive in our culture. So sitting with saying like, oh, this is outside of my comfort zone, of course it is, because that's how we were raised. But also, sexuality is really important, and you do deserve to feel good in your body and feel good with your partner. So I think even the fact that you're watching this video is already a step and gaining that comfort. You know, it doesn't have to be like, woohoo, like you can be okay with being a little nervous and meeting yourself or being a little self-compassionate. That's where you are, and take it to your comfort. There's places to purchase online if that's more comfortable for you. CalExotics website offers all of these and, you know, ships directly to your door. So it's not like if you're concerned about asking questions or things like that in a person setting, that's an option as well. And then there's people like me in the world that if you do have questions, you can ask as well. So lots of opportunities and resources to find the products in a way that feels safe and comfortable for you.
Right. That's helpful. And I do think these products come in unmarked boxes. They don't scream out sex toys. And keep in mind, you know, some of your most family-friendly realtors from Walmart to other places sell these products. So there's many ways to get them. And while CalExotics has a line that we think works well, if someone is looking, are there certain things they should be looking for or any recommendations that you have?
I think being reputable is really important. There's a lot of kind of things out there that are made of materials that aren't very vagina friendly. So there's certain things that you want to really make sure it's a reputable manufacturer, it's a reputable retailer, that it's an original product, that the company stands behind the products. CalExotics offers the 1-year warranties on the products. Silicone is a better material than some of the other materials because it's non-porous. So it makes it easier not only to keep the lubricant that you want to use in place, but it's not porous, so it doesn't get bacteria and things like in the material. Okay. So it's just a more hygienic, you know, nicer experience with the silicone.
So that brings up two other questions I have. One is, for many women who have hormone positive breast cancer, they can't use any kind of lubricant that has anything estrogenic. So just looking for recommendations on that. And then also, how do you clean and care for these products?
Great question. So the products can be, silicones, again, easier to clean because there's no little microscopic holes. So they can just be either rinsed with warm water or use with a specialized toy cleaner. It usually comes in a spray. You can just spray them down. and wiped down. So they're super easy to clean. And as far as a lubricant, the silicone lubricants tend to, again, just like silicone material, are not absorbed. So you have, they kind of stay slick on the skin, right? Like if you put something water-based on your skin and you rub it, eventually it will dry into the pores of your skin. Whereas silicone molecules are larger than skin pores, so they stay slick on the surface of the skin and until you wipe it off. So that might be an option. There is organic lubricants as well, and you can always ask a manufacturer to be more specific about the ingredients, but they're all listed. So it's like food in that it will show what's in it. So you can have an informed, decision-making.
That's great. So these are really good ideas. If anyone is interested in trying to use some of these products that might be helpful, but just on the higher level, Dr. Jill, I know you're based in California. If someone is looking for a therapist or a coach or someone to help them with some of their sexual issues, what would be the place to find someone who has the right credentials?
There's a few organizations that certify people in my field. ASECT.org is the American Association of Sexuality Educators, Counselors, and Therapists, and they have a directory that you can search by area. Same thing with the International Association of Sex Coaches, same thing. And I also work with people all over the country because I do everything by phone and by an app, which I've done even before the pandemic. So luckily I was able to fit right into this new model of how we work with clients. So that's also a resource as well. But those two organizations can also find you someone maybe in your area as well.
Right. Well, that's really helpful. And we will make sure to link all the resources on our website so people can find them. You know, we know a lot of sort of intimacy and sexuality is also just how you feel about yourself. Your brain is such a big part of this. And also your skin is your largest organ. And sometimes we forget that, you can discover other parts of your body. So I just think for our audience who might be struggling with body image issues, self-esteem issues, if there's just a few takeaway messages you want to give them about feeling better about themselves and trying to reclaim this part of their life.
Yeah, I think sometimes when we're facing something really huge, we kind of look at this big thing and it's so overwhelming. Like, I don't even know where to start kind of feeling. And so what I like to remind people is the fact that however you're even hearing this conversation right now is already moving forward. Like you're already past the start line. You've already started taking actionable steps to make these positive changes in your sexual life and your intimate life just by the fact that you're here. And so it can feel overwhelming, but you've already taken the first few steps. And I think that can feel really powerful and really motivating. I think also my framework for folks is there's not a problem to fix. It's an obstacle to outgrow. And that can feel very different. So if people want to call someone like me or one of my colleagues to get some one-on-one coaching or some help, and if they feel like, well, this means I'm broken, or what does it say about me that I need to call a sexologist? Or, and that can feel like really negative. And I look at it like, how can we grow your experience so that you're kind of overstepping these problems, that these are kind of in your past and you've outgrown them. And that feels really positive to people. So I think my takeaway message here is like, this is hard stuff, but you're doing it and you're already doing it. And this is something that can be really successful and happy for you in the end.
Right. Well, thank you. This is a lot of really great information. And we know whenever we cover the topic of intimacy and sexuality, it is among our most popular topics. So you are not alone if you are struggling with these issues. So please know there's a lot of resources, which is great. So thank you so much for joining us. So we encourage everybody to stay in touch with Living Beyond Breast Cancer. We have closed Facebook pages. You just log on to lbbc.org and we will connect you with those pages so you can connect directly with other women who've been diagnosed with breast cancer and have real-time support. So thank you so much for listening and take good care.